Big Ten powers collide for the Rose Bowl's inside track. For this man, a homecoming. Is he ready to prove his point?
Penn State was the best choice for me.
For Michigan, today is about revenge. For Northwestern, it's still about respect. And what does the Big 12 have in store for Nebraska? Kansas State provides an early answer. There are no easy answers to Oklahoma's questions. A once proud program is in disarray. Does this quarterback guru have the goods to mold Cal's signal callers?
Push, 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 back. That's it, eyes upfield, two hands on the ball, out of here.
Somebody will send a signal today, for only one can emerge the front runner. As College Game Day comes to you from the Horseshoe. Welcome to Columbus, a street name for a legend, one of the great settings for college football. Folks, it is wild here. They are ready for a big game. Nobody enjoys an autumn Saturday.
More ways than one. That's right.
Game day back on the road again. Chris Fowler along with the homecoming king of Columbus, Lee Corso. He brought his Indiana team in here a lot. And the guy they call Herbie, yeah. Kirk Herbstreit, in the crowd here, guys. I don't know if it gets much wilder. This day belongs to the Big Ten. We'll talk a lot about the Buckeyes and the Nittany Lions, but other stories in college football as well, Lee.
Well, Chris, the WAC has three teams in the top 25. BYU, Utah, Wyoming, with a combined record of 13 wins and two losses. They have beaten teams like Texas A&M, Kansas, Stanford, Iowa State. They are for real, especially at the top.
Coach, with all the conference games starting up, great time to look back at the non-conference games. The Big Ten has the best overall record in non-conference games. Two big wins. Michigan over Colorado, Ohio State over Notre Dame, the Pac-10 with Arizona State, and the SEC with the number one team in the country off to a pretty good start as well.
But you're right at the top because a great defense, as the Big Ten has been the dominant conference so far.
Yep.
Now, fundamentally, football, of course, a contest of collisions. Who can dish it out? Who can take it better over 60 minutes? That's the way Ohio State and Penn State have always played it. Two programs that symbolize power, strength, tradition. Their task today, typical of college football, respond from an emotional victory last week, come back, get ready for an even more important game today. Now, all parties appealing for calm here in Columbus in the event of an Ohio State victory last Saturday night, High Street. It starts just a few blocks from here, a couple thousand folks, several cars tipped over, some arrests, so John Cooper and E. Gordon Gee, the president of the school, go door to door on Thursday. They are pleading for calm. Of course, the loser today not out of the Rose Bowl race, but it become a much longer shot for the national title. The later you lose, the harder it is to get back up there. After a few September shakeups, the Rose Bowl stock is up, and a 1-versus-2 showdown in the Sugar Bowl is anything but a lock. In 10 games so far between top 25 teams, the higher-ranked teams are only 2-8. Rarely have so many played so early with so much on the line. The 21st, number 4 Florida at number 2 Tennessee. Both teams' conference openers, a season hung in the balance. The game left the loser on the fringe of the national title hunt. Next week, Notre Dame-Ohio State, a 4-5 clash that would leave someone facing a long autumn.
National championship's done. It's over. Season's over.
A Buckeye win left number 3 Ohio State in the championship hunt for this week's title elimination game, a 3-versus-4 matchup against Penn State.
Everybody's got the same goal when you start the conference, is try to end up on top, you know, and get to Pasadena. Boy, you can't hardly afford to lose a game against a team like Penn State this early in the year.
Next week, number 2 Florida State at unbeaten Miami. Could 1A be looking at only its fourth regular season without an unbeaten team? Only 17 remain. So that's where we sit as the Buckeyes meet the Nittany Lions. Last night, Joe Paterno quietly confident. I'll tell you, as you know, in Columbus, this Penn State team is being totally overlooked here.
Not by the fans, I think you're right. But not by the team. I think the one thing that people need to realize, everybody's talking about the physical ability of Ohio State, the way they're blitzing on defense. I think one thing that's being overlooked is the confidence of this football team. They have gone through some good times and bad times as a senior class. Look back to last year, chasing that national championship, losing up in Ann Arbor to Michigan, plus the good. Some big wins over Notre Dame and the big win against Penn State over the last couple years. These things have helped this team to believe. They don't go into games hoping to win. They now go into football games expecting to win, and when you have that edge, that's a big thing.
For Herb, watching Notre Dame in the Ohio State game from the sideline last week, I was tremendously impressed with free safety number 34, Rob Kelly of the Ohio State Buckeyes. Kelly has got good size. He's 6'2", 200 pounds, and he can move and blitz and do a great job. He has 4.5 speed in the 40. He can get deep on coverage as he does here. Rob Kelly is a tremendous football player. Now, the Buckeyes will go after quarterback from Penn State, Wally Richardson, and try to rattle him, because if they can stop the Penn State pass, they can emphasize the running defense, and no one's going to beat Ohio State with a one-dimensional offensive attack.
You know, Joe Paterno, George Paterno, everybody does know Richardson has to play well, and I like your guy Kelly. He's a strong safety.
Tough kid.
He's like a free safety. Yeah. He's got that towel there on his bicep. He's a thrash guitar guy. He's a great player. Anyway, in Dyke Stadium, the Big Ten's other big one. If Michigan walked into a Wildcat ambush last year, they are walking in wide-eyed today. They feel Cinderella is about to be paid back. Gary Barnett emphasizing old-fangled football, field position, good punting. He wants points from his offense on their first possession today. It's perhaps the toughest ticket in Northwestern history. Michigan fans swarming all over Evanston as Brad Nessler and Gary Danielson set the scene. Guys?
Chris, a near-perfect day, and today we'll get the opportunity to see a near-perfect running back. The top running back in the Big Ten plays at Dyke Stadium, and it's Darnell Autry. And he is a complete blend of speed and power and balance. He's a guy that's rushed for 100 yards or more in 17 straight games. Last week against Indiana, their defense did a pretty good job on him, yet he still scored 3 touchdowns, including one of 50 yards. Gary, what do you do against a guy like Darnell Autry? I mean, nobody's been able to slow him down. Michigan didn't do a bad job, though, last year.
I think that's really the key, Brad. Michigan, I don't think they change a thing. Last year, they had Autry under control in this football game. He busted a couple tackles, but with Jared Irons, they've got a guy that can match up physically with him, and they've got a secondary that are very good tacklers, speed that can match up with him. But you know, when Autry runs the ball, you just never know, like he did against Indiana. He busts a couple plays, and he can turn a 60-yard game into a 100-yard game. But like Darnell told us, that's not the whole game. My yardage, we can win different ways this
year. Right. He said 60, 70 yards doesn't matter to me as long as we win the football game. Something's got to give today, Chris, because Michigan only allows 94 yards rushing per ball game. Let's send it back to you guys.
Another great, typical Big Ten football game. Darnell Autry's not talked about it, but he does have a bruised tailbone. That's why Adrian Autry's been getting a few more carries in that offense. Didn't look slow last week, Darnell.
No, he'll block this out, especially in a football game like this. I think one thing to understand is I talked to Gary Barnett earlier this week. He said the magic and the chemistry of that special year last year began after the Michigan game, not the Notre Dame game. And I think they realize it's going to be very difficult to run the football. With that said, keep in mind Steve Schnur, the quarterback. Look for him to play action pass on first down, and his targets will be two very good wide receivers. Dwayne Bates is the difference maker, big-time game breaker. Great acceleration after the catch. Keep an eye on him. And also Brian Musso, he's also a punt returner. Good speed. He's a clutch receiver that can really make some things happen. Northwestern realizes to win this football game, they have to go back to last year, win the turnover battle. But I think the difference in this game will be Michigan's defense. Look for them to make a big play with an interception, Charles Woodson possibly. Michigan will win this game and get revenge for last year.
Well, Michigan's offensive game plan has always been to run the ball first. It's been in the past, it is now. But they're throwing the ball effectively this year to all the receivers in all the areas, especially deep. Now, Scott Drysbach has matured as a quarterback. He's 8-0 as a starter. Here he hits number 33, Clarence Williams, the running back, with a trick play against UCLA in the opening part of the game. Now, last week against UCLA, Michigan ran the ball for 300 yards, but they also threw the ball to 8 different receivers for 236 yards. That balance makes Michigan a tough team to stop. They'll beat Northwestern by 10 points today.
You're already looking ahead at the Ohio State-Michigan game.
Oh, yeah, that could be a big one.
You're supposed to like to hear what you have to say about that. That's right. Northwestern's defensive line is very thin, by the way. Hey, look, the coach is back. Coach Hayes, it's your nightmare, Lee. He's back.
Woody.
He's got the game plan in his hand. lot more on Penn State and Ohio State coming up. We'll also talk about the Huskers, their first road trip since that debacle in the desert at Kansas State. Tough ball game. And Lee will talk about the secret of the punt block success at Florida State. A lot more on Game Day from Columbus. Straight ahead. Good one.
Sales, Joe. There's always a future in sales.
Just think, Joe. You're going to be your own boss.
Joe, plastics last forever.
Joe, let's not call it a pyramid scheme.
Emu, Joe. It's the pork of the future.
Lots of career opportunities. One car, make it a good one. The Civic Sedan from Honda.
Joe, 12 men, one boat. What could be better?
When you buy a computer factory direct from Gateway 2000, our tech experts are there for you around the clock. What keeps them going?
4 hours. When I fix their problems, guys that I don't even know will just come out and say, I love you, Gretchen. I'm married. At least I know I still got it.
Gateway computers feature the Intel Pentium processor. And the only way to get them is to call 1-800-GATEWAY. You've got a friend in the business. Give us a call.
The way I see it, coaching against this Deion kid must be like sitting on a tack. Got your offense stymied, your defense bamboozled. What can you do? And just when you figure things can't get any worse, guess who shows up to return the punt? Prime time.
Oh, brother.
Anyway, take it from me, forget your fancy sports drink and get yourself some bicarbonate of soda.
Wall Street Journal keeps you on the cutting edge with news and insights that can affect you personally and professionally. Subscribe now and have the journal delivered to your home or office. And with your paid subscription, you'll also receive our free personal finance software to help you make smart decisions. Get 10 weeks of the journal and the software for only $3.80 a week. Call now, 800-356-9800. That's 800-356-9800 for the Wall Street Journal.
College Game Day is brought to you by Honda, vehicles designed to help simplify your life.
In Morgantown, the final real test for unbeaten Mountaineers before Miami comes calling. BC tries to do what nobody's done versus West Virginia in five games, scoring double figures, 55 tackles for loss. Knute Curtis is a pass-rushing monster. Meanwhile, Virginia unleashes its defense on Tech. The Cavs haven't trailed all year.
Well, big game in ACC. Virginia has what they feel is their best defense ever. Great size and speed with a strong front seven. And 33 straight football games with an interception last week, five turnovers against Texas. Question of the game, can the defense of Virginia stop Georgia Tech's running game led by C.J. Williams? They have 225 yards. I think they will. Virginia wins that game.
Meanwhile, elsewhere in the ACC, the Seminoles may be looking ahead of the Canes, but Thad Busby, with more picks than touchdowns, he must sharpen up. The O-line must improve. Look for it to happen after a players-only meeting. Lee, the special team's always good at Florida State.
Yeah, Florida State usually puts three men in the middle and blocks punts from the outside. Against North Carolina, they added number 11, Dexter Jackson, on the inside. The reason? They saw Syracuse almost block a North Carolina punt from that position. Dexter not only got one, he got two from the Syracuse position on the inside. Right there, Dexter Jackson.
Six times they've either blocked the punter, tackled the punter. Wide for Florida State tonight, so wing it. A lot of four wide. They will open it up. Look forward to play better. It's a 7 o'clock game on ESPN. The scoreboard show will follow that game. We'll wrap up the happenings on this October Saturday. Now, baseball, busy day today. Baseball tonight at 12:30. It's a matinee edition. Yanks and Rangers on ESPN Game 4. Then it's the Orioles and Indians over on ESPN 2 at 1 o'clock. Those of you expecting to see Michigan at Northwestern at noon, it'll be in syndication via Creative Sports Marketing. A lot more coming up from Columbus. We'll talk about the situation in Oklahoma, the great tradition of history. Well, the swagger is gone as the Sooners search for answers today. A tough ball game against Kansas. That and a lot more coming up. Baylor's one of only two Big 12 unbeatens. They are carrying the flag for the state of Texas. Every other 1A team there has at least two losses. Baylor takes on Texas Tech with a big play offense. Gerard Douglas duels Byron Hansbard. The Bears are the underdogs, though, by a touchdown. Meanwhile, Kansas State plays an already emotional game against Nebraska with heavy hearts. Co-defensive coordinator Bob Pope is hospitalized in grave condition after cancer was diagnosed last week. Kansas State tries for a breakthrough win today. As far as Bill Snyder has brought this program in the 90s, they have still never beaten a team ranked higher than they are. The last time they walked off the field with a win over Nebraska, Neil Armstrong had not yet walked on the moon. Today, the Cats players think that they sense the Huskers' vulnerability. Brett Musburger sets up the game for Manhattan.
Well, Chris, it's been a long time between victories. Coach, for Kansas State, you got to go back into the late 60s. 27 straight times they've lost to Nebraska. Now, Coach Bill Snyder has done a whale of a job here. But against this Nebraska team, he's up against a pair of great defensive ends.
Well, they're both outstanding football players with equal attributes. Now, Wistrom is a little bit taller. He's 6'5", 255, and he can come off that corner. You have to start your game plan and determine how you're going to pass protect this guy. Now, Tomich on the other side, not as big, but every bit as productive. You have to determine initially in your game plan, how are we going to handle the problems that these two guys present?
Now, offensively, Nebraska seems to be coming around after that loss to Arizona State, but there's still a lot of pressure on quarterback Scott Frost, Chris.
Absolutely. And on that offensive line, they know they let Scott Frost down in that ballgame when he needed help. They have to come around a lot better. Kansas State, last year, coming into that game with Nebraska, they had allowed 45 points. The Huskers hung 49 on them.
Well, Kansas State will put eight men in a box, and what they're going to try to do is stop the Nebraska run, then go after Scott Frost, the quarterback from Nebraska. Now, Scott is a good passer. People don't believe that. Watch Nebraska to counter with their passing game. Scott is an accurate passer. Remember, he was recruited to go to Stanford by Bill Walsh, not to run the option. If you notice here, he throws three or four different kinds of passes. This kid's a good football player, and I think it's his turn to come out and start to explode. Nebraska will start with the running game, but then Scott Frost throws the football, and like in Poltergeist, Jason is back. Nebraska is back, my friend.
Well, this will be a good game to tell us how far Nebraska has come since the Arizona State game. Scott Frost has yet to prove that he can throw the football. He's done it in scrimmages, done it in practice, but in this football game with Kansas State crowding the line of scrimmage, look for Nebraska to lean on the old and reliable, the offensive line. The offensive line has to be able to be productive to take the pressure off of Scott Frost. This offensive line, because of this loss to Arizona State, teams now think they have a chance against Nebraska. The best way for the Huskers to break the will of their opponent is to physically just beat up on them. Nebraska's offensive line is well-schooled up front as anybody in the country. With three returning starters back, they're 6'3", over 300 pounds, one of the biggest offensive lines in the country. It's very, very important for Nebraska to win this football game. They've got to be able to get that offensive line going because, as of right now, Scott Frost has yet to prove that he is a passer.
He will today.
Nebraska, if they can get that win, look out. One of these two teams is going to drop below them. The Huskers climbing back. You say there's going to end up...
He's open.
He makes the prediction and he sticks with it. It's homecoming in Norman as the Jayhawks and Sooners continue the longest uninterrupted rivalry in 1A. Kansas smarting after a loss at Utah. Oklahoma really smarting after three losses to WAC teams. The young Sooners carry a school record six-game losing streak into this game. It's a very tough stretch in their schedule that's coming up now. OU hasn't even led a game at any point since last October. As the worst season in Oklahoma history looms, the famous Sooner swagger has become a stagger. But for a change, the Sooner Nation is sticking together and searching for hope.
As we went 0-3, you know, it's very tough. You know, it's been hard for me to fathom.
I don't think there's a simple way to explain what's going on this past 8 weeks.
It's a shame that you have to lose, learn how to win. And the mistakes with young kids, but that's part of it. Hopefully, we'll win some games before the season's over.
John Blake never imagined his dream job would be this tough. But then Blake has never barnstormed the state making bold predictions, a fatal mistake by his predecessor.
You know, it seems amazing, but it was exactly a year ago this week. Our college game day set was right here. The Sooners were playing another unbeaten top 10 team in Colorado.
Confidence was very high. Howard Schellenberger was telling folks what they wanted to hear. He was talking about a seventh national championship, about a football team they would write books about, make movies about.
Well, when I talk about national championship, instead of seeing people do this, I see people doing this.
But the head shaking began soon after, as the overrated Sooners became shakier by the quarter.
Howard Schellenberger's ball club just coughing up a fourth and two situation.
Howard dug his own grave. He came in to a situation and misjudged talent. And if he didn't misjudge talent, he flat out lied to the public.
We've been in denial here for a while. You know, we just can't believe that we're in this position. It's taken us time to get here, Chris. This just didn't happen overnight.
Enter Blake, XOU nose tackle, who was hired as Barry Switzer's liaison to the players and later followed him to the Cowboys. Brian Bosworth credits Blake with keeping him and other Sooners out of trouble. But after Blake's first OU coaching stint ended at 87, anarchy reigned.
I know what it takes to win a national title, and I know what it takes to be in a top 10, but I also know the embarrassment you can have that you win those goals, and the next day you have disaster in your program because of kids being on drugs, or someone getting shot, or someone doing something illegal.
So Blake sees himself as counselor, confidant, and role model. He's perhaps the only football coach ever to publicly quote Hillary Rodham Clinton.
To raise a happy, healthy, and hopeful child, it takes a family.
Blake says it will take the whole Sooner family to raise the football program back. But he knows the same folks who turned on Gary Gibbs, then Schellenberger, will eventually demand wins.
My purpose when I step on that football field is to win. I've been a winner all my life. I say I'm going to coach hard to anyone. I think I know X and O's better than anyone. I can just recruit just as good as anyone. My goal is to go out there and win football games.
What he's establishing now doesn't relate to victories right now. It does in the future, because that comes with acquisition of talent and doing the things that they're doing right now.
What no one knows, how soon these Sooners can be taught what the great OU teams always knew, that they would win.
This program was built on confidence from the Bud Wilkinson days through the Barry Switzer days. This program was built on confidence in pulling out games from behind or going out and laying half a hundred on people because you were better than they were.
I don't think there's a fear factor on the other side. And the thing that concerns us as coaches is there's not that confidence factor on our part. You know, that was one of the first things I noticed when I stepped foot on campus was the lack of confidence that hey, we're Oklahoma. You know, we can do whatever we need to do to get it done. And we've got to get that back as coaches.
These are sobering times on campus and across a proud state.
When you have to look forward to a game with Oklahoma State is your only possibility of a win, you know your self-esteem's a little low. There's no swagger, walking back with your chest stuck out anymore.
The Sooners themselves remain surprisingly upbeat, but urgency is growing.
You know, there comes a point in time, and it needs to be soon, that the young guys step up and start playing like veterans.
Have you been able to push out of your mind what people are now saying is possible, the ultimate nightmare, a winless season here?
Oh yeah, that's not even a thought of mine, because I know that we're going to win some football games before this season is over with.
People are all taking shots at Oklahoma, and I think they deserve it. We had our shots back, but they need to do it now, because Oklahoma's going to be back. We'll have our chance again.
The question is, how many chances will they have to win games this year, given the tough schedule ahead? A two-win, a one-win, even a zero-win season is a possibility there.
Well, Chris, in my opinion, there's an uncontrollable, vigilante-type atmosphere at Oklahoma, whatever or whoever it is. That atmosphere chewed up Gary Gibbs, and he won over 70% of its game. It took 1 year to get rid of an excellent football coach in Howard Schellenberger. So I think it will get John Blake. It will get him also if Oklahoma doesn't show some uncharacteristic patience and loyalty. They got major league problems at that school off the field.
I agree with you. I think the program is in jeopardy right now. But think of the players. Three new coaching changes, not only the head coach, but assistant coaches in 3 years. These players have had to endure that and had to try and stay focused and stay confident. Listening to the Oklahoma players, it's good to hear that they're still confident. But the worst thing they can do is start to finger finger point. They need to maintain their confidence in this new coaching staff and believe that they truly can get something going, because right now, three coaching changes, top to bottom, that's tough to endure.
Blake has been a disciplinarian. Starters have been suspended, I think, by problems off the field. You're not talking about the players getting into trouble. You just mean the atmosphere of the boosters around there. Interesting. Barry Switzer used to recruit by taking a box of rings to a recruit's home and showing him all the championship rings. Now, John Blake has to recruit with the same kind of methods that teams recruiting against Oklahoma had to use. He has to sell the chance to play right away and the chance to build a tradition instead of maintaining one. All right. Big week in Columbus. Vice President Al Gore, speaking of recruiting, was out trying to win over Voigt on the Ohio State campus. And a suggestion here in Columbus as a running mate.
Look at that.
Herbie for president. What are you like? You have to be 35, right?
That's right. That's right. That's right.
We'll get back to the Buckeyes and the Nittany Lions, the pass rush. The Buckeyes will unloose today against Wally Richardson. And Curtis Enos, Penn State running back, his story is straight ahead.
My racing around, weekends can get kind of busy.
You can bet Shelly Anderson will make time for the National Hardware Sale at Sears.
I could use a few things for the car.
Like this Craftsman 13-drawer chest and cabinet, just $299.98. Or a Craftsman 75-piece mechanics tool set, only $59.99. This weekend, get to the National Hardware Sale at Sears and Sears Hardware Stores.
I'll be checking it out in about 4 or 5 seconds.
Report to me by 5. Honey, 5.
You can kiss that promotion goodbye, Shorty.
Your accountant's on line 1. The audit's next Tuesday.
Your wife's on 2. And where's the dry cleaning?
Yeah, where's the dry cleaning?
Life getting a bit overwhelming? Try the simple thrill of an Accord coupe. From Honda.
In an age of streamlining and downsizing, Chili's still makes its Big Mouth burgers by hand, one at a time, by a person. What this lacks in efficiency is more than made up for in taste. Chili's Big Mouth burgers, monuments of inefficiency.
Play football at Chili's this season. In every restaurant, you can win 2 round-trip tickets on Southwest Airlines to anywhere they fly. A football or Chili's Big Mouth burgers, all just for playing.
The Sports Center has been so huge over the years. All kinds of spinoffs have been created. There's been Sports Center, the Saturday morning cartoon.
Hi, I'm Keith Olbermann.
Hi, I'm Dan Patrick. Welcome to the Big Show.
Sports Center, the concept album, and who could forget Sports Center, the movie?
Dan,
but I'm not like the other sportscasters. You make me feel in fuego.
There's the halftime whistle as the clock counts down. A wild scene in Columbus. It is the game day halftime. Time to check out one of the great traditions in college football. Kirk tells me the band here actually bigger than the football team. The sousaphone player can be a bigger star than the quarterback. Here's the tradition of Script Ohio.
The Script Ohio, first of all, is a drill that was developed and performed in 1936. The director was Eugene J. Weigel at the time. And it was very unique then and continues to be, in as much as it is the writing out of Ohio, very similar to a person writing with a pen. And the climax of the whole routine is the dotting of the I with the sousaphone player.
5, 6, 7, turn. The eye dotter is one of the biggest things that could possibly happen. It's when 96,000 people are looking at just me for what I'm doing. The drum major will start and lead them through the big O, and you know, we'll go all the way through it. And I'll start out 28th spot in the conversion block. This isn't a follow the leader where the drum major just tells us where to go. Everybody knows exactly how many steps it is between every part of the Ohio, so we have to hit it just in the right place so everything hits right. At the bottom of the O, he'll pick me up, and I'll do my double rights, take me around the bottom of the O, and we get to the top of the row, gets to the dogfight section of the regiment, the boom, 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 boom. We're coming to the top of the O here. Give the drum major five, and we strut out.
Even if you're not a Buckeye, that kind of gives a chill up your spine. I love the band uniform. They have uniforms to practice, and they have hundreds of people come out to watch band practice. We saw it here yesterday. Back to the football game, and speaking of big guys, Orlando Pace lined up against Brandon Noble. 70 pounds, the biggest Penn State defensive lineman, gives away to the pancake man as they throw around pancakes behind us here. What about the guy behind Orlando Pace, Stanley Jackson?
Well, Ohio State uses two quarterbacks, but in my opinion, Stanley Jackson should play every down. The reason? He can run and he can throw, but most importantly, he makes the big plays. Here's a perfect example against Notre Dame last week. Watch Jackson scramble and get up to set up the first touchdown against Ohio State. I like that Jackson at quarterback. Even after losing three of the top 10 NFL picks, plus a Heisman Trophy winner, the Buckeyes are outscoring their opponents 171-23. Great offensive balance. That's why I like the Buckeyes.
Jackson really came of age last week against Notre Dame. Really is starting to show confidence. I think with Ohio State coming into the season, everybody knew that the Ohio State defense was going to be strong. The one thing people were surprised to see is the way new defensive coordinator Fred Puggage has installed this blitzing attacking style. They have a nickname. They go by the Silver Bullets.
We feel that if we have 11 silver bullets to the ball every week, that we're going to come out on top.
Silver bullets, that means a lot. I mean, it's an attitude. 11 silver bullets, whoever it is, whoever the 11 is out there, just running to the ball and having fun and making plays.
At Ohio State, the silver bullets have nothing to do with women's baseball or that mysterious masked man. In Columbus, the bullets are 11 Buckeyes looking to disrupt anything they deem offensive.
We've recruited some speed here in the last couple of years. We've got some really fast guys on defense, and if we fly around, that's and you know, play our assignments and fly around 11 silver bullets the ball, there's nothing that can stop us.
The Bullets are an offshoot of first-year defensive coordinator Fred Puggage. The Buckeye defense ranks sixth in the country in points and yards allowed behind a wide-open, all-out attacking approach.
Been a lot of talk about the linebackers being freed up this year and being able to just turn them loose. I mean, you look at these three right here, they've done a nice job so far.
Well, again, everything we're doing on this is we're trying to push the ball east and west. We feel we have pretty good team speed, and we're trying to get the ball running east and west and hopefully run it downhill.
Our four defensive linemen just have to hold our gaps up front, you know, and be able to, when the time comes, to get off the blocks and, you know, the linebackers just flying to the ball. And we got our safeties up in there, and, you know, Rob and Damon, they've been doing a great job for us just flying to the ball.
If they're not, you know, locking down receivers, then we can't blitz, you know, pretty much. And same goes with playing coverages where we're getting the safeties more involved. You know, those guys are kind of out there by themselves. They've got to play great football.
We match up with our corners on wide receivers. We play our safety still back in a run support scheme. Okay, we're reading flow. Our linebackers are not involved. Again, same principles. Safety zoning up and playing through the quarterback's eyes to the ball.
We're mature now. We play together for 3 years now, and just the attitude of everybody getting to the ball and the idea of silver bullets, you know, every man getting to the ball, giving 110% effort.
Maybe this year we can blend everything that's happened to us, you know, and put it all together this year, you know, all the big wins and, you know, maybe the things that we messed up or did wrong, you know, maybe if we can just blend that all together that, you know, we'll have the kind of season that people dream of.
Well, one thing, Chris, you can expect to see, Ohio State had a lot of success last week blitzing. Same thing today, but Joe Paterno has seen it on film. He has a week to prepare his team for that attacking style today.
Don't think the Penn State receivers strike fear in the Ohio State defense, though. That's part of ABC's regional package at 3:30. In fact, 53% of you will see the game here. As for Cal USC, the Trojan suspensions mount. They face Pat Barnes and the Bears. More on that later in game day. Is this a blimp shot for Ohio Stadium?
In case you want to with the numbers.
Male fully. Now that's a cake, folks. 112 man hours, 144 eggs, 1 gallon of oil, 96 pounds of powdered sugar. They sell pieces of this cake to support a scholarship program at OSU. The Michigan flag on that stadium there is upside down. The Notre Dame flag is at half staff.
You got stats for everything.
A lot more.
You come up with stats.
Enos, a Buckeye native who said no thank you to Ohio State. And also, we'll talk more about Troy Davis and Iowa State. That ball game and the SEC wrap-up is coming up.
time. Ooh, it's the football team, your beauty queen. It's why we're right nearby. And best of all, it's thrifty, renting cars in your neighborhood. Ooh, best of all, it's thrifty, coming through like you knew we would.
All right, gentlemen, tomorrow, your butts are mine. Lights up.
Miz, I'm hungry.
Russell Athletic Wear is made to handle the toughest situations on and off the field.
Hot dogs.
Crisp fries.
Hamburger.
Tacos.
Tacos grande.
Pizza.
Coach?
Going somewhere, ladies.
Hard work.
Dedication.
Commitment.
Get Russell Athletic. Get tough.
Get up there. Large butt. Go, go.
For years, ESPN has been working to improve sports for the fan.
Designed to extend the season for fans in places like frigid Lambeau Field, the Toasty Ball is heated by a small plutonium furnace. But at 130 degrees, it's too hot to handle.
But experiments like Toasty Ball did lead to a breakthrough in coverage for all sports. ESPN Net Sports Zone. With Chris Mortensen's column, drive charts, everything you need to be a better fan. ESPN Net Sports Zone. Technology for you.
In Death Valley, some bad blood. Some Vandy players labeled former coach Gary DiNardo inhumane this week. DiNardo and the school still $150,000 apart in the negotiation of his buyout. So Vandy vetoed LSU's usual request to wear the traditional white jerseys at home. The first visitor to do so, and they do have the right, LSU will be in purple. Meanwhile, in Tuscaloosa, it is homecoming for the Crimson Tide and also for ex-Bama man Bill Curry, who was run off there. For Tim Couch, quarterback for Coach Curry, his baptism continues against the fourth-ranked pass defense. The Gators just chewed him up in his first college start. 6 of 18, 13 yards, and a pick. Another tough assignment today for the young guy. At Auburn, Terry Bowden will call plays from the press box today. 5 days after surgery on a herniated disc in his neck, Bowden finally pain-free. It had been so agonizing he couldn't sleep. He said he'll be back on the sidelines next week. He's going to enjoy calling plays from the press box today, he says. Now, following the Fiesta Bowl last year, Florida sophomore Mo Collins may have made a mistake even more painful than the loss to the Huskers. School officials investigating whether or not he accepted $500 from an associate of an agent. That would be an NCAA violation. In the meantime, he will sit out a suspension that starts today against Arkansas. Here's what they have to do to reshuffle the line. They'll flip the right tackle over to the left tackle, move the right guard to right tackle, and bring in a new right guard. And that could make Danny Werfel sweat. Pardon the expression. Collins protected his blind side. This is a rematch of last year's SEC championship game. That was 34-3 when Florida wasn't as good as they are now, and Arkansas was a lot better. So how do you like the Hogs' chances today?
Not good. You can forget about that offense line. It's not going to matter. Florida's offense will be in great field position today because of the play of their defense. They will be getting after Arkansas all day long. Defensive end Tim Beauchamp, 6'2", 255-pound sophomore. Only thing I can say is quarterback Pete Burks for Arkansas better have an insurance policy. This defense will come after him all day long. Florida wins this scrimmage to get ready for LSU and Auburn coming into Swampland.
Scrimmage. Six defensive touchdowns already for Florida. That's how many they had. This is your stat, Lee.
That's right. Don't joke.
Last 4 years combined. Arkansas's offense only has 7 touchdowns. Meanwhile, Mississippi State, they're trying to start 2-0 in the SEC for the first time in 10 years. Georgia trying to salvage its season. They already have an SEC loss, and the Florida and Tennessee games are coming up. Now, last week, State really schemed South Carolina's offense right off the field.
Again this week, Mississippi State is my upset special of the week. The reason? Joe Lee Dunn, the defensive coordinator, will start to blitz the Georgia team as soon as they get off the bus. Blitz, blitz, blitz causes Georgia problems. I like State in a real good close game defensively.
Blitz, blitz, blitz.
Blitz, 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 blitz.
And Georgia's season is over. That's on ESPN2 tonight. Ooh. Well, if they lose the ball game, it's right. Urgency. Okay. It's okay. Urgency as the Dogs take on the Dogs over on the Deuce at 7 o'clock Eastern time. A lot more coming up on College Game Day from Columbus. We'll have the picks of this game still ahead. And also Pat Barnes at Cal, the secret behind his emergence. Troy Davis at Iowa State on pace to do something very, very special. But we'll show you the tough road ahead for the Cyclone tailback.
Sad, isn't it? Finding out you paid too much for your stereo. Circuit City. You can't find a lower price. We guarantee it.
Honda invented the ATV, and in over 25 years, no one has taken the idea farther. Now, with the purchase of a 4Trax 300 or 300 4x4, get a Magellan GPS satellite navigator. So no matter where on earth you go, we can help bring you back. And with any new Honda 4Trax, get one of the best deals on earth. No down payment and 13.5% APR financing.
Watch out. This is as rough and tough as it gets.
You think you're tough? I would be up there.
Sports Illustrated knocks you over with the hard-hitting new video, The NFL's 100 Toughest Players of All Time. Plus, you also get this exclusive Sports Illustrated sweatshirt. Both the video and SI sweatshirt are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. Get into it with Mad Dog, LT, Dick Butkus, Greg Lloyd, and more. It's the toughest show on earth. See it free from SI. You also get free this authentic, great-looking, heavyweight Sports Illustrated sweatshirt. It's a classic package so impressive, you won't believe it's free. When you order 54 issues of SI for only $1.48 an issue, save over 55% off the cover price. Use your credit card. Call now and get both great gifts free from SI. A sports experience like no other. Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
Welcome back to College Game Day in Columbus. If you have a 2.8 grade point average and you get the luck of the draw, you can actually have a dorm room inside this old stadium. You can look out your window, watch the band practice in the parking lot. You can go to the concession stand for all your needs. Kirk tells me they're not the most luxurious dorms in the world, but hey, the tradition, the history.
That's right.
The house that Woody dominated, you can play pool in the basement of it. Now, for those of you expecting to see Michigan and Northwestern over on ESPN2, the baseball playoffs have caused a change in game plan. You can see the game on Creative Sports Marketing in Chicago. The game can be seen on WBBM-TV in Detroit if you're Wolverine country, WXYZ. Otherwise, check your local listings. Now, the guy carrying the offensive load for Penn State today also carries a bit of a grudge against Ohio State. Ohio native Curtis Enos believes he was treated shabbily by Ohio State's recruiters, who have since been replaced. He even got mail from OSU addressed to Chris Finis. Last year, the Buckeye native outrushed Eddie George, the eventual Heisman Trophy winner for Ohio State. In the stadium today, Enos would love to put on a show. Reese Davis visits with a happy man in Happy Valley, happiest when he's on a football field.
He's one of those guys that likes to run through people rather than around them.
He's running over safeties when he can make them miss.
It doesn't matter a whole lot who's in his way or what's in his way. He's just going to try to run straight ahead.
Curtis Enos is not easily knocked off course. A year in prep school, a stint at linebacker, really only served to delay his heroics at tailback here in Happy Valley. In fact, no matter what obstacles been placed in his path, Enos has greeted it pretty much the same way he greets a free safety in the open field. Head on.
All the learning experiences I've had has made me into a person to accept, you know, adversity and being able to overcome it.
And the hurdles were high early. At tiny Mississinewa Valley High School, Enos was Ohio's Mr. Football in 1993. His hometown, Union City, embraced him as a hero. But some in the other nearly all-white neighboring communities did not. At times, opposing fans came out of the stands to yell racial insults. During a bus trip to a game against arch-rival Ansonia his freshman year, Enos saw slurs directed at him and his brother plastered along Route 47.
My brother and I were two of the best players on our team, and we were scholars. And they felt that that's the way they could get into our head to distract us from playing well. And now I look back on that, I think that made me into a better young man to learn from mistakes.
A lot of people can say racism, and, you know, that really doesn't matter. It's just how you look at it and how you take it, you know. You can't, just because you're a black guy or a Mexican or somebody like that, you can't hold that, you know. That doesn't stop you from becoming who you are and all you can be.
Determined to go to Penn State, but lacking the standardized test scores, Enos enrolled at Kiski Prep, 2 hours west of State College. Initially a huge disappointment, Enos turned the rigid coat and tie to class lights out at 11 detour into a blessing.
They really grew you up. You're around kids that want to be things in life, you know, succeed in life. So I thought it was a great, great place to be for him.
Opened up my maturity level, and, you know, my views broadened a lot on situations, especially with racism and the different types of ethnic groups that were there. I think that was the most productive year of my life so far.
For Enos, the productivity that's now measured in yards once was measured in tackles. The school that recruited Jim Kelly as a linebacker made Enos one for preseason practice and one game last year. The short tour of duty left a lasting impression.
He hit just as hard as any linebacker I've ever seen.
I was the happiest guy on the team because I didn't have to block him anymore. He was as good as a tailback as he was. I thought he was a better linebacker. He was phenomenal at linebacker.
I just love to play the game, regardless if it's playing linebacker or tailback or center or guard or defensive end. You know, my heart's here at Penn State, and regardless where it's at, you know, I just love the sport that much.
A love that has him running full speed ahead to an emotional homecoming.
He attended an All-Star game with some Ohio players, Orlando Pace and the other guys, almost talked him into switching to Ohio State. Some Buckeye coaches at the time felt that he had given them kind of a promise. He ended up honoring his commitment to Penn State. Can you imagine Enos running behind big Orlando Pace?
Wow.
He's just one of the great running backs who's chasing Troy Davis. 229 yards a game, 917 yards in four games, 378 last week, Fort Lee's upset pick. But look ahead what he's got the opportunity to do. Be the first guy ever to rush for 2,000 yards in back-to-back seasons, but look at the competition. Those are the last four games, what he did last year. If he kept on the pace, 2,500 yards, it's amazing.
We got Byron Hansbart, has had four 200-yard-plus performances in five games. He averages 7.6 per carry and 206 yards per game. He's a great football player.
He's a big-time back. I like June Henley out of Kansas, averaging over 200 yards a game, already 10 rushing touchdowns, on pace to become the all-time Kansas rushing leader. Unbelievable 10 touchdowns.
Tiki Barber leads the ACC in all-purpose yards. He's having a better year than any other back in the ACC, and that includes Florida State's Warrick Dunn. He's a great All-American football player.
Down in the SEC, Kevin Falk of LSU. Now, Kevin Falk has great speed, great explosion. Look at the acceleration once he gets out in his secondary. And because of that, he's averaging 133 yards a game, 6.9 yards per carry, and another great, great running back this year. He's chasing a lot of good ones.
Coming up, we'll shift from running backs to quarterbacks. The guy who helped make Brett Favre so great, proving his wonders at Cal. As we continue from Columbus, these folks like Pepe Pearson, we didn't mention him. Picks are still coming up.
I've been their biggest fan for nearly 10 years. Stuck with them from thick and thin.
Over 500, under 500.
Didn't matter. They're my guys.
Then they built this new stadium!
Sweet. Let's hear something else. It's gonna be big. New coach, new offense, new attitude, whole new game plan. This could be my season.
Softly gathered leather seats. 10-speaker audio system. Walnut wood trim. 310 pounds of torque. 4.4-liter V8 282 horsepower engine. Dr. Jekyll, meet Mr. Hyde.
The 1997 BMW 7 Series, the 740i, $699 a month, $5,000 down.
Troubles and took game three in Arlington, but Juan Gonzalez and the Rangers are looking to make their first postseason visit a long one. The Yankees-Rangers today at 1. The division series continues on ESPN.
Warwick Dunn and the Seminoles think they're the top team in the Sunshine State. Saturday, ACC rival Clemson comes to Tallahassee to battle the Noles. Clemson, Florida State, tonight at 7, only on ESPN.
Who wasn't thrilled in San Diego when the Padres clinched the postseason? Their co-tenants and Jack Murphy, the Aztecs, to today's scheduled game with Air Force. Pushed back to Thanksgiving because of the baseball series. The Aztecs, 3 weeks between the win over Oklahoma and next week's game. But the key part, they have just 5 days to prepare for the option offense of the Falcons, who will have 12 days to get ready for that game. It could affect the WAC title. Meanwhile, to the Pac-10 now. In the Coliseum, USC is shorthanded four starters, three of them on defense, thanks to Sneakergate. One-game suspensions for Lombardi finalist Darryl Russell, linebacker Sammy Knight, safety Brian Kelly, and wide receiver Larry Parker. They swapped the football shoes given by the school for apparel at a sporting goods store. Sean Walters still sitting out his suspension. You want to be at full strength on defense when you take on Cal. One of the quiet unbeaten teams, they've won four straight track meets. Rookie coach Steve Mariucci, he's considered a quarterback guru. So Mike Adamley went to Berkeley to check out the system that's bringing the Bears out of hibernation.
The pictures in Steve Mariucci's office are a tribute to his last success story. As the Green Bay Packers quarterback coach, Mariucci was the mastermind behind the maturation of Brett Favre. From third-string Atlanta Falcon to the NFL's most valuable player in 1995.
You know, he still calls me and critiques me after a game. You know, you're throwing off your back foot and all the things that you've done well over the last 4 or 5 years.
Mariucci loves to teach, and now he's schooling a new student in the nuances of the West Coast offense. Class is in session, and the lessons are intense.
Ready? Hey, let's go.
Front shoulder down so you can throw a flat pass.
Eyes upfield now. Eyes upfield. Tackle line of scrimmage.
What are you reading on this guy right here?
I'm reading his depth, width, and hip.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful. Yeah, it's good progression.
You'll see a safety over the top of this guy, yeah. So I knew
that guy
off the edge was
coming. You're okay here to go to Dragon. This is a good check.
Push, out! That's it. Next guy.
I get to come up here and learn something new every day. It's probably the best thing that could ever happen, I think, for the University of California, and I think for any quarterback that's going
to
be here.
It took me about 3 minutes to decide that this guy really loves football, and he's going to do whatever it takes to be the best guy he can be.
Mariucci didn't bring just his reputation. He brought the whole Green Bay Packer playbook to revamp the Cal offense.
It's very multiple in formations, and it's a decision-making kind of system where you got to do the right thing with the ball. So you got to have some smarts, I think.
It's the type of offense where you can't really key on a certain player because the ball goes everywhere.
I had to watch a lot of film because he brought some Packer film, which was the same place. So ultimately, I got to learn from somebody who made mistakes within the system.
This is a good job. Came back here and gave him a little bit of a look on the post, and that was well thrown because you didn't have much room to throw that ball outside. I mean, that looks like Favre the Robert Brooks on the backside corner in the red zone.
But how do you ingrain a complicated system like the West Coast offense, which takes years to master, especially with a quarterback who's a graduating senior?
There's going to be some times where he just isn't as sharp as the pro guys because there isn't enough time that he can spend.
It's like, you know, you can't learn it all at once, so it's just like you try to repetitively put it in your brain every day so eventually that it might stick.
Another disadvantage for Mariucci, the bond he formed with Favre hasn't translated to Berkeley.
We were close, and our families were close, and you can do that in Green Bay because it's such a small town. We lived about a 9-iron apart, and he spent a lot of time over with my family and babysat my kids.
I remember when he first came in, he's just like, you can't call me Mooch. We're not friends. We don't really know each other yet. We will. You just got to be patient.
When I finish this year and look back at it, it won't be so much the wins and losses, more so the have they really bought into what we're doing here.
Slide, push, that's it, back, see ya.
Now, Coach Mariucci looks so young, but that's deceptively because he was even on one of your staff, so I know he's been around.
Yeah, well, Steve worked for me when I was the head coach at the Orlando Renegades of the United States Football League, and he did a great job. What made him such a special coach, he has a great rapport for the players, they have great respect for his knowledge, but also he's very loyal to them. When the United States Football League folded, he went to work for the Los Angeles Rams, and guess who the coach was there? You got it. John Robinson. Well, today, my friend, the teacher beats the pupil in a high-scoring game. Robinson will beat Mariucci today.
Yeah, Coach, I was out there a month ago in Berkeley. I had a chance to spend some time with Coach Mariucci. Very confident and aggressive coach. And right now, it's rubbing off on his team. The best thing that California will do is throw the football, but they also can run. They have each game, they have a 100-yard rusher in each football game. With that balance, they will stay in this football game with a great offense and could be a shootout. But I really think their defense is still too young to be a threat in that Pac-10.
Yeah, they're giving up almost 30 points a game.
They're real young.
They have some quality offense. Get that West Coast defense. Cal, really one of the quiet unbeatens. There are 17 unbeaten teams coming into today. This is by far their biggest test. That number could be trimmed down to a dozen after today. Well, they don't tailgate anywhere else like they do here in Ohio. We're trying to investigate whether or not this is kielbasa or sausage. What do you, you're the expert. Is that
brats? That's just brats. Midwest brats.
That's from Wisconsin.
That's right.
That's a Wisconsin game.
They can do it here
in
Ohio.
That's next week.
We're coming back with picks on the Buckeyes and the Nittany Lions. Speaking of kielbasa or sausage, here's a guy who's had a few in his day, Cecil Fielder and the Yankees. They were on the ropes a couple days ago. They go for the clinch against the Rangers. Game four coming up following baseball tonight, which is just minutes away on ESPN.
The biggest fest this month isn't Oktoberfest. It's Ace Fest, where you'll find all the help you need for fall at prices worth celebrating. Ace Fest, one more reason, Ace is a place with the helpful hardware folks.
Before introduction, a Moen faucet is tested at least a 500,000 times against leaks and drips. So it's hard to find a more reliable faucet, no matter how you look at it. Moen, buy it for looks, buy it for life.
Passport.
Yes.
Special financing now available.
Every Sunday, the McGinty's play 3-on-3, followed by a mandatory review of game film.
I think initially I had a slight advantage, but then slowly but surely, the boys were catching on. And I have to admit, they weren't half bad for their age.
So not only did we become better players, we learned the science of analyzing game footage.
Science, I like that. Kind of makes me a scientist.
Kinda, yeah.
College Game Day is brought to you by Ace Hardware. Ace is the place with the helpful hardware folks.
Game here in Columbus, two games on the other end of the spectrum. Nevada, the number one ranked offense, faces the defense in UNLV that is ranked dead last, number 111. Temple and Pitt, it's homecoming there. Now combined, Temple and Pitt have scored 165 points in their last nine games. Ohio State alone has scored 171 in the last three games. Let's break down this ball game. You talked about concerns in the kicking game if you're a Buckeye fan.
Absolutely. I like Ohio State's speed and power, but I question their place kicker and their punter. I'm not so sure they're great.
If you're a Penn State fan, I think a guy to keep an eye on really is going to be Wally Richardson. Wally Richardson has got to go out today and play well because of the way Ohio State is going to plan to attack them. He could have a big game through the air.
Joe Paterno says his defense is underrated. Ohio State does have the big physical offensive line, but I saw them against a pretty good offensive line against against USC. And Paterno assures us and everybody else that that defensive line will not get pushed around. They may get worn down. That's the key. Can they keep that defense up?
Well, I think the best thing going for Penn State in this football game is the fact they come in as an underdog, close to a 10-point underdog. They will be very excited to come in. Curtis Enos, an Ohio kid, is going to be very excited. But I think the difference in this game will be the difference in attacking the line of scrimmage, the blitzing. And you're going to see a big Ohio State offense line. I like Ohio State 24-13.
All right, good pick. I tell you one thing. Buckeyes! Ohio State number one! All right, can you see?
They found a way to muzzle them. I take it, Lee, you like the Buckeyes.
Oh. I like the Buckeyes.
We'll be back here later tonight. Up next, baseball tonight, Gary Miller and Peter Gammons. Then it's baseball on ESPN, the Yanks and the Rangers.